George, I'd like to talk to you about the long-term management of your pulmonary embolism.
Oh? I thought I'd nearly finished the treatment. I've been getting heparin every day through this trip.
That's right. After the initial diagnosis, we heparinize patients through the IV route. That's to prevent more clots from forming. Heparin is given through a drip for 5 days. Then we change to anticoagulant tablets.
Oh, I see. Is that what you mean by long-term management?
Yes. You'll need to take anticoagulant tablets for at least 3 months when you go home.
What kind of tablets do you mean?
I'm going to prescribe a tablet called warfarin.
I think I've heard of warfarin. It's called a blood thinner, isn't it?
Yes. A lot of people call it a blood thinner because it makes blood flow through the veins more easily. That means that your blood will be less likely to form any more blood clots.
Okay.
There are a few things you need to know about warfarin. You'll take one dose per day, with your evening meal just afterwards. It's important to take every dose at around the same time each evening.
Right. Take my tablet every evening.
Remember that because you'll be taking an anticoagulant, you have an increased risk of bleeding more easily than normal. You may have nosebleeds, bleeding gums and bruising.
Will that always happen?
It mostly happens in the first few weeks of treatment. But there are things that can make it more likely. For instance, you will have to be careful with your diet.
What? I have to go on a diet?
No, nothing like that. There are just some foods you need to avoid. You should avoid foods which are high in vitamin K, such as leafy green vegetables.
I see.
Also, you'll have to have a regular blood test at your GP's.
Why is that?
It's to check your UIR, or clotting rate. To make sure that your warfarin dose is correct.
Does the dose change then?
It can change depending on a few factors. The UIR gives your GP an indication of how effective the anticoagulant is. The GP will increase or decrease the dose, as needed.
I understand.
The last thing is to make sure that you always carry your anticoagulant alert card with you. It's very important, especially if you undergo any surgical or dental procedures.
What sort of card?
Don't worry. You'll get the card before you are discharged. There's also a leaflet on the foods you should avoid.